Hello everyone, welcome to the Practical English Brand. Today I'll be explaining perfective models. The words that you see over here are called perfective models according to English grammar. Should have, could have, would have, must have, might have, and may have. Keep in mind that we do not use will have in this case, or can have, or shall have. Plus verb third form. Let's begin with Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Speculation for situations. So first of all, I want to explain the short forms of these words, which are used commonly in daily English. Instead of should have, should have, or even shoulda. Could have, could have, or coulda. Would have, would have, or woulda. Must have, must have, or musta. Might have, might have, or mighta. May have, may have, or maya. I mean, written English, usually native speakers, they write of, like of, but it's according to grammar, is not correct. But just keep in mind, if you see this kind of, forum, you should know that they mean, instead of should have like this, should have or should have, the short form. Now, what's the idea, the first idea? Look at the first example. I should study right now. So we use this modal auxiliary should, and it gives a present meaning. Like right now, I should study. In the second example, I should study tonight. I should study tomorrow. I should study next week. So, there's modal auxiliary should, and we use it for a future meaning. What about the past? Can we say I should study last night? Does it make sense? No. So, in this case, we need perfective modal. I should have studied last night. Today, I had an exam and I was not able to get a high score, so I should have studied last night. Now, look at these words talking about speculation, like, you speculate something. So, should have is used for advisability. For example, you say there's a situation, like you say, this morning I took an exam and I was not able to get a good score. So, somebody's telling you, you should have studied hard last night. So, it's kind of like advisability. It was advisable for you to study hard last night. Now, for example, you say, one of my friends is mad at me. And someone is asking you why. And you're saying, because I did not invite him to my brother's wedding party. So, now your friend is telling you, you should have invited him. So, it's kind of like advisability. Could have possibility. There's a situation again, for example, you say, I saw somebody who was arrested by the police. The police arrested him and they were taking him towards the station, police station. You say he could have committed a crime. See, possibility. It's possible that he committed a crime. So he could have killed someone. He could have stolen somebody's money. He could have robbed a bank. So you talk about possibility. It's your speculation in the past. Would have condition. For example, you say, I would have been in the United States if I escaped from my country, or if I went to the airport during the first days of Taliban's arrival in Kabul city. Okay, I would have been in the United States if I'd wanted to leave the country, for example, okay? Or I would have bought a car if I'd had enough money. I would have bought a car if I'd had enough money, see? So, when you talk about condition, must have, it shows like kind of obligation or certainty. Obligation or certainty. For example, again, you say, I wanted to take a trip to my province, but I can't because, my car doesn't work, it's out of order. And someone is telling you, you must have fixed it yesterday. You must have fixed your car yesterday. Or for example, there's again the same situation and you see someone who is arrested by the police and you say, he must have done something wrong again. You're certain about that because you already know that guy. You know that guy is a criminal. So he must have done something wrong. He must have committed a crime. Might have and may have, both of them show a probability. For example, if it's the same situation, you see somebody who's been arrested by the police and you speculate that situation, you say, he might have committed a crime. So there's a probability because you don't know exactly who that guy is, but you just show your probability. I mean, it's probable that he committed a crime, or he may have or may have committed a crime. Okay, this much is enough. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Have a great time, and